Yeah, I think that it is a common opponent for us in the fact that we play them every year, and it's a healthy relationship and healthy competition that we have with their staff and their program. We're going about preparing the same way we always do. So our process has been the same this whole week as it normally would be, with a single game on a Saturday. And yeah, we're going to have to put in some serious work here, guys. Watching the film on Dartmouth, they're a very good program. They're definitely on the rise. And there's a couple key things that they do that are going to be a big test for us.
With two straight weekend sweeps and this time to say a 5-game win streak, is there just like a different kind of optimism right now? Like how's the locker room feeling with such a success happening?
Yeah, obviously some success brings some pride, some confidence into our room. But I think our guys kind of had that pride. I know I've mentioned that to you guys, that they've had pride in that logo all season. It's something that they talked about as a group back in August, and they want to push the program forward. So I don't know if it's changed that much for them inside of that room. Now, it's always a better feeling when you're winning rather than losing, and I would say the optimism is high for them, you know, just after putting in all the work and getting some results for it.
You talked about after last weekend's sweep about how when you see the guys put the product on the ice and it works, that it can make you emotional as a coach. I'm hoping you can expand a little bit more as to what you've seen specifically that you've done differently that the guys are really taking to and really showing on game days.
Yeah, well, you know, on the topic of what I said after the game, when you look at a single player from our seat, I think any coach will tell you, you kind of picture the whole story, right? Like the whole recruiting story and talking to their parents and them coming to campus for their visit and when they got here. And, you know, for some guys like Will Zapernick, it's, you know, being a young freshman and growing all the way to what he is now. And so you envision all that, and at times the emotion can get a hold of you, coach, and you kind of go big picture and can live back through that story of each individual guy. And when you watch them have success, you know, you think of like Nick Ahern, who came in very late to us and scored a really big goal for us in that UMass overtime win, right? To envision Nick and how he's grown and his story as a coach, as a human, I think it makes you a little bit emotional. For our guys, I think it's a little bit of them, you know, it's a mixed group in a sense that some of them really signed on for a dream, right? Some of them that we recruited a few years ago, we weren't winning a lot of hockey games, and we talked about how we were going to grow, and by bringing in the right people and getting the right group together, to now see them kind of starting to take a step there, and by no means are we a finished product. They don't hand out championships in early January, and we know that. So, but to see those guys start to push the program forward and make the program take a step when they came in with really a promise of nothing is something that, as a coaching staff, you're proud of.
How do you kind of keep the mental edge, knowing all the success you guys have had recently, also knowing that you've got a whole ton of Hockey East games coming up after this, and this is just one game series, a team that you're only going to see this one time, you're only going to play this one last non-conference game. How do you kind of make sure your team is mentally prepared and know what they've got to do to go out there and try and win this one game?
Well, I think it's an understanding that previous success doesn't equal future success. And it's also an understanding that, you know, you wake up in the morning and you're entitled to nothing. You really are. You know, nobody's going to give you the gold medal, like I said, in January, early January. Nobody owes you anything as a program or an individual. You've had some limited success because of what you've done as a group and how you've worked through a process and stuck to an identity. So, you know, the moment you start thinking you're really sweet is the moment that and think that you're entitled to something, that's the moment that you start to the world will, you know, make you realize that that's not true. And Dartmouth doesn't owe us anything, and we're not entitled to anything else. So it was our guys understanding it, understanding that fact, and us talking to them about it. And again, getting right back to our process and our work ethic and our identity, and we've done that over the last couple of days, and hopefully that puts us on the right side of the ledger against a really good team in Dartmouth. Well, I think for us, every game is absolutely individual, and we don't talk about that at all. We really are focusing on just today and then tomorrow, and then, you know, everything that leads into playing Dartmouth, and we take it one step at a time. My sole focus this morning is getting ready for this video session we're going to do in 15 minutes, and it really is understanding that if you don't focus where your feet are, anything that you future dream about is really not possible. You got to take care of today and the moment. Otherwise, talking about what's after Dartmouth or rides home from Dartmouth is just something that I don't think will set us up for success. We got a strong test ahead of us, and we got to take care of business today to even have a chance at winning that game on Saturday. Well, they're unbelievably coached by Reed Cashman and his staff. I know that staff pretty well. I went to school with Troy Thibodeau. We were teammates. He was a freshman when I was a senior. And I know the work ethic and recruiting that he's bringing. Jason Tapp and Reed Cashman have been around college hockey. Reed's been to the NHL and back. And I've been on New England districts with him for USAs at different age groups. So I know that they're going to bring the intensity that matches their coaching staff, and then they're going to have the details. You know, Reed grew up through his coaching ranks through Quinnipiac. You know what Rand Pecknold and Quinnipiac have built there and what a juggernaut that team is. And I think Dartmouth's well on its way to doing the same thing. So we can expect to see extremely high work ethic, extremely detailed team, and their skills growing through their recruiting base. So I think that's why I would say they're on the rise and they're really taking a step as a program, and they're going to be a tough opponent for us.
Thanks, Steve.
Thanks, guys.